packs at least a dozen tires that are sitting here because they have the air bubble in the top that allows them to float. This is a pretty nice pond. A lot of nice lily pads and everything. Okay, just for you know, this water, once you get into it like 5 feet out, it just suddenly drops. Like, it's like so deep. If I was to walk out further, I would just go under. So that's why I seeked out that longer stick. I noticed these tires are actually pretty old. They have those white wall rings. All these things are super old. They don't make treads like these anymore. Like that one over there, it's got those thick treads on just on the edges, but not the center. That was a big challenge. I just had to take like a 10 minute break. I was so out of breath because this is like a, I don't know, at least a 45 degree angle going up this steep hill. And I didn't even actually get them to the top. They're like in the top 5 feet. So I gotta stack them up there neatly. I really hope I don't come back down here and find that the railroad employees just threw them back down here. Because it's clear where they came from. I ripped up all the ground with my feet coming down. I got one more tire that's coming up with me right now. That pond is like way down there, like 100 feet away. And on my way up, I shook the ground a little. Like an avalanche of tires. I caught all of them but two. And I had to go all the way back down and get two more. So, hopefully someone doesn't throw them back down there. It always makes me feel good getting some junk like that out of the environment. Like, that pile there, somebody could just throw that back down there. Hopefully that doesn't happen. I really hope they take that away. Because this is, I can't be lugging this stuff down here. Now that is what I call a dirty job. I was being splashed with mud. Every inch of me is just covered in this nasty stuff. And the worst part of it was there was a bunch of these tiny little red worms all over the place. Not sure what they were,